Once again, good morning to all of you. So since the clock is ticking, I'll start as soon as possible. So we are from FWWB. I'm Nilanjan Chaudhary, and with me I have got my colleague Himanshu Baghela. So we work in what is called the credit department of FWWB. So regarding FPO and association with FWWB, I'll just start the thing. Means we are doing actively FPO financing and capacity building of FPOs from 2009 onwards. So initial years means it was small, so we are doing some small projects with the Ford Foundation, then HEVOS. So that built up the base. So in last 2-3 years, we expanded the program and we did a lot of FPO financing. So over 2009 till 2020, so we had provided loans of 100 crore plus, along with 100 plus APCs we have supported. In last 3 years, mainly we have given loans of more than 70 crores from 2017-18 onwards. So we have expanded the program literally from 2017-18. And along with the loans, we are always doing capacity building activities of the FPOs. So we'll just run you through the presentation, and maybe means wherever you require more details, we can go into a question answer mode. It's okay?
Yeah,
sure.
This is introduction to FWWB, just one slide we just wanted to run through. Like, it was started in 1982 by Ila Ben Butt, and it was apex organization, as we all know, in microfinance for providing capacity building and as well as credit support to MFIs, which is woman-led max and other NBFCs. So currently we are providing, we are into agriculture finance, solar and water and sanitation, and capacity building to FPOs as well as entrepreneurs. So we work with direct entrepreneurs to build their capacities in terms of business planning, cash flow, marketing, and soft skill training we are providing. So next. So this is basically specific for agriculture finance. We have started in 2007. We have supported this Professor Trilochan Shastri's MAX in 2007 for procurement of groundnut. So later we managed to get support from Ford Foundation, and Ajit sir was there for at the time of sanctioning and all. So we have got support of Ford Foundation to start FPO lending in a huge way. Then we managed to get support from HEVOS, NABARD and NAP Kisan. So currently we are working with major relief funds is coming from NAP Kisan, and we are also using our internal fund for disbursement of loan. So these are current activities. So current partners are 32 with loan portfolio of 22.74 crore. And we are providing technical assistance to FPO. Current partners are 32. So these are purpose of loan, like procurement and loans to member for purchasing of agri inputs. So these are all some purposes for which we are providing loan. Cumulatively, we have provided loan to 106 FPOs, amounting to more than 105 crore amount, out of which 84 are FPCs, 14 are cooperatives and MAX, and 8 are Section 8 companies. So which are into agriculture and, you know, which are providing doing procurement from FPOs and farmers. So this is basically our growth slide. In 11-12, we have started with 2 FPOs. Then we expanded in later on, and in 18-19, we have supported 24 organizations. And in current year, we have already reached 30 organizations. So this is loan disbursement. We have started with 1 crore. Majority of disbursement happened in last 3 years, because in 11-12 we were also learning stage, and we developed, we have tried lot of rating tool, and you know, and we now don't call it rating tool, we call it need assessment tool, capacity building assessment tool, because to call it rating tool is very harsh on the FPOs. So that is why now we are calling it a need assessment tool. So
rating. So we initiated this rating of FPOs through CRISIL. So the FPOs came back to us and said, sir, what these people are asking? Hello. So we don't know even how to answer their questions. So again, thing is that means they are equating all those FPOs means with SMEs. So they were not ready for giving all those kind of information, etc. So again, we went back to MCRIL. Then again, we did all the checks, what are applicable to FPCs, what are not applicable to FPCs. And again, we came back with another ratings of another 8-9 FPCs. And it was more conducive for FPC rating in that way.
Out of this 8 ratings which we have conducted, only one FPO got above average score. Otherwise, everybody was in below average and, you know, that kind of situation. Next. So this majority of loan utilization went for procurement from farmers because that is the main business FPCs are doing. So credit services, recently it has started. FPOs are providing loans to members, but it is also a very dicey situation. We are also in dilemma, what should we do? Should we continue with that model? Because FPCs are not ready for that kind of activities. So it is advisable that we should stick with procurement as well as agri-related activities. If they go into a credit services, then it is altogether a different ball game. So we were skeptical at the beginning also, but we have piloted with southern-based organizations, but we need to see, we are still discussing on it, whether we should continue with that activity or not.
Maybe when he has raised this question, so what we have did, means overall if we see, means we have disbursed a lot. So many of you will be thinking, so what is the quality of the portfolio? So over the period of years, means from 2009, if you see, the overall means we can say that it has run smoothly. Apart from 1 or 2 years when suddenly the portfolio quality deteriorated. But again, we have achieved back. So that is the thing. But again, what he is saying is that the majority of the defaults came from the credit portfolio, which the credit activities which the FPOs tried to do. So mainly means what he is saying means we are of the opinion that the FPOs maybe are not suited for lending business at the ground level because they don't have that capacity to do credit activities. So initially means we thought 1 or 2 FPOs means they did well, but those FPOs again went into problems after third cycle of lending. So means we are now not encouraging FPCs to do lending business at the means as their business. So mainly where we can have the control on their cash flows, where the FPCs can have the control on the cash flows. So those activities are mainly encouraged by FWW. Yeah.
Sorry. So I have to, you know, we have to close at 11:40, so that's a warning to them and all of you
who have. No, cooperatives also, cooperatives. But majority default came from FPCs. Max are doing good in terms of that.
Average ticket size, 50 lakhs on an average loan size is right. Minimum 5 lakhs.
5 lakhs we start.
Maximum 1 crore. 1 crore, 2 crore also they have taken. Is the average.
Just we'll run through this, then we'll open up the discussion.
One suggestion that you have is that, see, the presentations, with your permission, will all be shared with everyone.
Yes, we can do that.
Yes, you have to. Just wanted to know that these defaults happen because of fraud failure or there are other reasons?
No, there are a lot of things. Means thing is that it's because sometimes, means mainly we gave for dairy loans or goat loans. Sometimes they said ki the goats died. Sometimes they had the feeling since the, what is called, since government has waived off agri loans, so our loans will be also waived off. And also because of elections things. So those are the things. Means. Yeah. FPCs means who promote it, means they don't have what is called
systems
and also don't have proper grasp on means the whole system of doing credit. So that was one of the main things which came out. Also the thing is that there are a lot of ground level realities means which we need to face means while we are doing means if they are doing FPC financing, because sometimes political activism comes into play. So all these kind of things means plays a role. So we can have an offline discussion on this, means why FPC shouldn't do what is called
lending
business, because there are a lot of other factors. Because microfinance institutions are a different type of entity. They're doing these things and they have got proper control. But for example, means Max, etc., who are doing credit activities for a long period of time, so they know their customers, so they think, but here means they don't have a proper collection systems, processes. So all these things You can say deteriorate the portfolio quality over a long period of time. And also insurance, etc., all these things for cattle, animals, whether they are taking it properly or not, all these things also play a role. So there should be very close monitoring. It's not that we have stopped. Yeah. But thing is that there should be a very proper agency who is monitoring all these plus activities, like insurance activities. The thing is that where is the supply of milk going on? So whether they have got market for the milk, etc., needs to be very closely monitored. So we are doing all these things, and only we are giving a short term or small amount of loan, so wherever it is possible.
So the idea was to develop activities of the FPCs, because they need to give monthly salaries, monthly expenses to the employees. So if they will do only agriculture with one particular seasonal activity, then they will not become achieve that kind of sustainability.
Yes, right.
Without proper
MFI. Yes, yes, correct. Yes. Correct. Yeah. Correct. Right. Correct.
FPC. Yeah.
We have to stop in 1 minute.
Yeah.
We also have another constraint, as the next presenters have a flight to catch.
Okay.
And I don't, you know, because finance can be complete, as I warned earlier, you know, finance requires a whole day, and there's going to be a separate finance table during lunchtime. Mm.
So what we'll do, we'll directly move to capacity.
No.
Yeah.
Since we have got 1 minute, so I'll just present this slide. So apart from the what is called credit activities, so this slide speaks about the capacity building initiatives which FWWB has always taken up. So we always believe that along with finance, capacity building activities are required. And also the traditional trainings which we gave for years are not what is called suitable. Some of the APC CEOs write to us that we have attended 30 trainings, but it's not reflected from the work which they are doing. So ultimately, the thing is that what we require is that the accounting trainings, proper maintenance of on-the-job training, maintenance of accounts.
Operation.
So all these things needs to be done. And as there is, we have opened one AFC in Tamil Nadu.
Agri Facilitation Center,
where all this kind of support will be given. Actual job-based support can be given. So which can help in improve their accounting systems, then governance, then things. So actually the financial part can be taken very, because we are facing a lot of problems because reports don't come to us, so they are not able to give timely reports. So all these problems which we are facing, so we are trying to solve these kind of problems through this.
So basically they need on-the-job training, day-to-day operation while they are facing the real issue. They need support at that particular time. So trainings and all, it will increase their awareness. But at the time of that particular problem, they need strong handhold support. So that is why we have established one Agri Facilitation Center. And now after that, we are also focusing in spreading across the India also, because we have our partners throughout the India. So we are assuming that after the success of that, we are still in process of impact study. After that, we'll make certain changes and modify the method, we'll discuss on it, and then we will implement in other areas just to make my FPCs sustainable. Otherwise trainings and workshop, it will not solve the problem. It's very difficult.
And last thing is that the business part, so we are giving it as a grant part, but what happens when the grant is not there? So the sustainability part always is a problem. So thing is that whether the APOs will be able to do the systems and processes or to sustain themselves, the business should be sustainable by itself. So that's one of the things which we need to take care. And we are always seeing that it's a very fluctuating business.
Uncertain.
So the APCs which are there for 8-9 years also, sometimes they are in good shape, sometimes they come down, so that's a problem. The sustainability is an issue. And once the fund grant support from NABARD stops, from SFSC stops, from FWWB stops, so what next? The sustainability we'll have to check. How do we do that? So that's one of the key learnings for us.
It's a very bumpy ride for FPCs. Last year they did business of 2 crore. This year they will not do anything just because one crop failed. So the diversification of activities is very much essential. Otherwise, it will end up doing nothing in 1 year. So there should be no continuity.
Yeah.